फर्स्ट ऑप्शन वेस्टर्स लिंक, वेस्टर्स लिंक आई एम गोइंग टू टेक सिलेक्ट दिस डेटा व्हिच आई नीड टू कॉपी इन वेस्टर्स लिंक, विल कॉपी कंट्रोल सी, गो ओवर हियर, सिलेक्ट पेस्ट एंड देन वेस्टर्स लिंक, other paste options, these are available in paste station, this is it, okay. So you can see here, this is given as paste link, okay. I'm pasting it. What I have done, I created a link, for each cell. So Amita scored 20 runs, here it is 20. Now if I'm changing it here, it will also reflect here, okay. 15. Also I'm getting 50. So I'm not copying this data. I have entered the data as link cells, where the links are starting from here. These are the initial cells. Moving to the next one, pasted as picture. Okay. So I'll first delete this picture. How do we paste as a picture? These are the cells. When you copy this data and you paste it somewhere else, you will also get this data in the cells. But what if you want this data in the picture format? Then you need to again copy, go to paste, click the next option, picture. Okay, click this. Now you are having a picture. This is not the data in cell, this is a picture. Look, when I am trying to double click on any cell, it is not responding because it is a picture. The data is not in the cell. Okay, so this is normal, and it is a picture. But again, this is not a live picture. When I am changing this value, let's say Amit has also 50 runs. Not getting the 50 here. So this is not a linked picture. That option is also with us. Again, I am copying this data. Control C, going to test, and then clicking on linked picture. So now I've created this linked picture. Look at here. When Vivek has scored 101 runs, let's say Vivek has scored 25 runs in. There it is reflecting here. Okay. Is also changing. So this is a linked picture. Whenever you need data in form of picture but not in cells, and you also need that data in the live format. That means, I mean to say, whenever you are trying to change some input and you need to replace the same input in form in the format of a picture, you will have to use this linked picture as paste. So I think I have covered this paste as linked picture and linked picture. Meanwhile, if you are having any doubt, please click me on. Okay, I will move forward. Next, you are having transpose and live transpose. Okay, again, the same data I'm considering for the example. This is the list of players, and these are this column is the runs, the player, and score. So I need to transpose this data. You know how transpose works. The column will be converted into row. Okay. So this first column it will be converted into row. The second column it will be also converted into row. This is how the transpose works. So how do we get the transpose in Excel? Very easy. Again, there are two ways. First. That is also available in this station. What we need to do is create transpose. So select the data. Am I audible? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Is it going fine?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Whenever I need to create a transpose, what I will have to do, I will copy this data. Again, it's control C command. I will come here. Wherever you want to create the transpose of this data, go to that cell. Right click, go to spacer, and you are having this option over here, transpose. Okay, this is the option you need to use. Let me run it. What I'm getting? I'm getting the transpose of the data. So this was the first column. I've received the same column in the row format. This was the second column. I've received the same column in the row format. Now let's move ahead. Now what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to change the runs scored by each player. So let's say when initially Amit has scored only 20 runs, we will say Amit also has done a century. So 1-0. Scored 1-1-0 runs. Now we are not getting this 1-1-0 for Amit here. So this is the transpose, but this is not live. We need to create a live transpose for more interactive data transmission, data switch. For the effective use of Excel, we need to create the live transpose. So again, how to create a live transpose method? We are going to execute, but it's a different one. Again, I'm copying this data. Now, what I will have to do? Given some theory over here, what we need to do? First, we need to select the transpose location with array size. Start typing the selection. After completing the formula, you need to type shift plus control plus enter, not only enter. Okay, generally how we do put the formula in the Excel, go on typing it, some bracket what we need to calculate, and then write bracket something, and then just go on with enter. This is how any normal formula in Excel works, but this is not the case with advanced transpose or live transpose. What we need to do to create a live transpose, we need to first select the array size. What is the array size for the input table? And getting this, we see on the left corner here, it is 5 row and 2 column. Okay, it is showing in the top left corner, 5 rows and 2 columns. So I will select 2 rows and 5 columns. This is how I need to select. So okay, so I have selected the array and the location where I wish to import this transpose. But I wish to import the transpose. I will start with formula transpose. Okay. What I want to create this data for transport. I'm completing the bracket now. I'm not directly going on with pressing enter. I need to press control, shift plus control plus enter. That is how I'm getting the live transpose. If I directly go on clicking enter, I will not get this value. Okay, so this is now the live transpose. Let's check it. Let's go back to 20 runs for Amit. Look at here. Let's go back to Michael 0. Getting 0 for the equal. So this is the live transpose we have obtained. So the method. Okay. Let's move on to the further part. The next is charts and spark lines. These are available in insert tab. Okay. So this is another example taken. Let's say in production of a farmer who has planted his cultivated his first he harvested onion, then grapes, then mango. So what was his sales profit? That means I mean to say net profit in lakhs. So in 2017 year he got 4 lakhs profit. In 2018 he got 5 lakhs profit for onion, and in 2019 he got 6 lakhs profit for onion, and similarly for grapes and for mangoes. This what are these values? These values are the sales profit in each year. Okay, so now I want to analyze this data in graphical format. Okay, so what are the options generally regularly available with us? We will create a chart. Okay, so chart. Generally, what we do, select this data, we go to insert. These are the options available for 30. So insert column chart, horizontal column chart. There are different options available here. I will click recommended chart. What this option will tell, Excel will automatically recommend the best possible solution or the best possible orientation for your data. So I think this is good for me. Okay, this is good for me. I think I will go with this data. Okay, I will go on with this chart. Now, I've generated a chart of this data. What the chart is telling us? This blue color is for 2017. Red color is for 2018. Below you can see 2019 green color and 2020 it is violet color. Okay, so these are, and the bottom it is showing the production type. Means for onion, it was for 2017. This was the sale in 2018. This was the sale in 2019, and this was the sale in 2020 for onion, for grapes, and for mango. Now, how do we further enhance this charting? So go to axis title, click on this. So I have multiple options over here. I will just click on axis title. Also on data labels, so that I will be able to easily see what are the values of the cells. So again, I will click on data labels. Where do you want to keep this data label? This is also available. Now, present, I will be having this outside pane. What are the data labels? These values. This value 6, 5, 4 means for onion in 2017 here, because 4 lakhs profit. So this is 4, it is shown here. This 5 for 2018, this 6 for 2019, for 20 because of lockdown, let's say the production came down. So it is 3 lakhs only for onion. Okay, so this is year wise and production wise graph we are getting. So this is the problem over here. It is what it requires somewhat a large space in the document. These are the charts and these are the trends. What I am able to see, it is increasing for onion for 3 years, then it went down. Okay, and for grapes, it was 3, then it increased to 4, then again it came down to 3, and then it came down to 2. So from what I am getting the trends here, for mango, I am seeing an increasing trend, 1, 2, 3, 4. So every year, in case of mango sales, the profit is increasing with 1 lakh. Okay, so what I am seeing here, you can also add the chart axis titles, you will see sales profit. How to do the axis level. You can see here production wise, year wise, chart title. This is the chart title. What is for this? Another option available with us is path lines. These are the path lines available. So what are we having in path lines? First we are having lines with columns, then non layers. Okay. Create them. Okay. So the problem with the graphs is this small graph for this much data, it will get this much space in the document. Okay, now if you want to further increase it just to see the trend, it is taking this much space in the document. Then you need to see only the trend, not your interested in the bigger size data. What we generally do is we create spark lines in form of line, in form of columns, or in form of win or loss situation, depending on the application. Okay, so I will create them. Let's say we need to create lines, data lines. these data range. Okay, this is the data range for 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020. Okay, for each of them. So then location. From here. Where you want the spark line to be placed, location range. Okay, this is how you get these spark lines. Also showing us the trend. So look for mango, it is continuously increasing year wise. Look for the third line, it is also showing you. Okay, so the same trend which we received from the graph increasing order, we received the same trend in a single cell, over here. So this is also how we do it with columns and Binor loss. What works is Binor loss. Whenever there is a value which is less than 0, let's say minus 2, it will show a negative. It's shown a red part. So whichever value is greater than 0, you will see the same magnitude blue line, and when you are entering the value negative magnitude, negative sign, we will see some red column here. That is, you are getting in our loss situation. And these are the columns. In the same way, we generated the spark lines. In the same way, you can also generate the columns. So, what are spark lines? These are nothing but the data graphs which are accommodated in a single cell. Okay, so this is a single cell. This is value G4, this is G5, and this is G6. This single cell gives you the trend of these four data points. Okay. This was all I wanted to tell you about this spark line. Let's move further. So next, we are having a slicer. This is also available in insert tab. Okay. So, what is a slicer? I've taken this example over here. These are the different company shirt sizes and postings. So what are the company available? I will tell you this. Start with the initial. We copy this. Paste it here. Okay. So this is normal. This is normal now. Okay. So this may be the data you will be having. Paste it again here. Now, what is the general requirement for creating a slicer? First, you will have to create this data in form of a table. So, to create this data in form of a table, you can click here, or this is also option available with you. Format as table. So, in both way, you can create this table. Generally, the Excel selects the most appropriate location for your table, and it is 99% accurate most of the times. If it is not, then you may drag the selection and choose your data accordingly. Now, I am checking this. My table has headers, company, size, and cost in rupees. These are my headers. So, I will go on with this. Okay, now what Excel has done? Excel has converted our table in. Our data in form of a table. Now what we can do further, it is a drop down list. I need to only see the search for Allen Solly company. I will click on this. Now only the options available with this company Allen Solly are highlighting here. The small size, medium size, and large size. what are the pricing for the company. Again, if I need to see for some different company LP, then I will be able to see it here. Okay, so this is generally how we do it. The more appropriate way, to do it will be like this. Just this is the array of your table. Click on any cell, go to insert, then this is the option. You need to click slicer. Okay, so it will ask the traders if you want to enable. I will enable all of them here: company, size, and cost. I will say okay. Now this is how you get a slicer. This is more interactive than going here and then again selecting what I want. This is more appropriate for interaction. For size, when I need to see only the options available for medium size, in this way I will be able to see the options available for medium size. This is the general way to analyze the data. How we do it with slicers, these are the slicers available. I can also increase the size if the data is not. Okay, so now I have got all the tabs which I can vary. Now if I want only Allen Solly company data in this table, I will only click on this thing, Allen Solly. Okay, so it is highlighting only that. I'm creating, I'm removing this filter, go to medium, it is showing medium. Okay, I'm clearing it. I only need to see permission. Okay, I only need to see the cost, 3000 rupees, it is showing us clear. So for any way, in any combination, so Allen Solly, then I want to go for medium size. That has done here. So this is more interactive way to do the data analysis, to look at a table for analyzing the data trends. Okay, so this is about the slicer I wanted to tell you. Again, further, and let's next thing is text to column. This is a simple requirement many times. Again, there, this is the example I've taken. Suppose in the first cell there is a name Mahindra and next one Mahindra Singh Dhoni. Okay, so in the first cell it is written Mahindra, then in the next cell it is written Singh, and then in the cell Dhoni. Now what I want, to combine all these three in a single cell. So this is where we use this formula, concatenate. This is the formula concatenate, which is used to join the strings, text strings. So how you do it? Equal to. Equal to C. Is equal to concatenate. Okay. This is the command you need to use. Click on it, then select the first thing you want with comma, and what it is asking, the second text what you need to connect. This is second text, then again comma and the third text. When you complete this bracket, what you get is like this, Mahindra Singh Dhoni. But now, as we can see, there is no space in between the words. Now I also want to add some space in between Mahindra and Singh, and in between Singh and Dhoni. So this is how generally name looks like. So what is the way to add the space? Again, space is also text. After comma, I will create this double inverted, and I will insert only space. I'm pressing space bar. Okay. So this is the space I've inserted, and then comma. So what is my second text here? I've created my second text as space. So in between A4, that means in between Mahindra, and in between B4, that is Singh, I've created a space like this. Okay. So whenever you want to insert any text, you need to use it in between double inverted comma like this. Okay. So this way I have inserted space. Again, I will create some space in between B4 and C4. Now, you click enter. You see a space between Mahindra and Singh and Dhoni. Okay. So this is how you combine different cells in a single cell. Now, what is the way to reverse it? The command we have used to combine this is concatenate. Okay. Now, let's look at the way to reverse it. Now, this is also a general requirement when we have the data in a single cell and we need to create it in different columns. For example, many times we are having the names of a student, let's say Mahindra Singh Dhoni, or let's say any name you can imagine of the student, Mahindra Singh Dhoni. Here I am taking an example. I need to create each word in a separate column. Okay. So what we done in the previous case, the cells had different value. I combined all text in a single cell. Now I am trying to reverse it. I am having the same data in a single cell. I need to create this data in separate cells. So his name in separate cell, his father's name in separate cell, and surname in separate cell. It means in different columns. So the way to reverse it, deleting, copy this cell. That is a simple technique. Copy this cell. Go to data. Copy this cell, go to data, select the location where you want to insert this data in form of columns. Click on this thing, text to columns. Okay, this is where you need to click. Your data was selected. Fine. Column. We need to insert it here. Now we'll be able to do it. Okay, this is how you do it. There are many options available in delimit and fixed width. I will go with fixed width presently. These are the arrows. You can select them anywhere where you need to create a break. So after M, you need to create the further part in the next column, you can select it here. So I don't require this presently. My data in this form: Mahindra in separate cell, Singh in separate cell, and Dhoni in separate cell. So click on next. This is how we will be able to. Okay. This is how we have received it. The first name in one column, father's name in different column, surname in different column. Okay, so first name, middle name, and surname. That is in different columns. So this is how text in single cell can be converted into multiple columns, or the text in multiple columns can be converted into a single cell. Okay, so this was just trying to tell you about the way to convert a text in a cell to multiple columns. Further, next we have with us is remove duplicates. Okay, the way to remove duplicates, we are having some random numbers here, 194, any number. Again, you can add 57, 76, 55, 59, any number you can add, go on adding. So let's say we are having a very big list of numbers here, and what I need is I need to filter this data, and I need to only extract the values which are unique. That I mean to say, this is one, and again I am receiving this one, taking this one here. So this is one, again this is one, so this is a repeated value. I want to remove all the repeated values of this data. This may be big enough, and you can do it with a single command. So this is data presently I am having. occupancy count, 32 numbers are there. So out of these 32 numbers, if I am trying to delete all the repeated in manual method, I will have to I was telling you about how do we remove the duplicate cells. So I've selected this data, click on data, click remove duplicates. So it is asking whether I need to go with present column B. If presently we are having only one column, so this is only showing this one column. In a particular case, when you will be using this command, you will be having multiple columns, and then you will have to select the proper one in which you need to create this. You need to avoid the duplication. So in present case, I am having only one column. I will go with this column B. Say okay. So what it is showing us, 7 duplicate values found and removed. Now 25 unique values removed. So in all, you can see here the initial count was 32. Among 32, the 7 values were repeated. So what Excel has done, it has removed these 7 values. Now only 25 unique values are remaining. So we can check them. I'm selecting all. Now it is found. It is 25. So whatever the duplicate values were there, those are removed. This was about removing the duplicate values. Let's move on to further. Trace dependent precedence and how do we remove the arrows? Okay, this is also a general case. This is not an advanced, let's say, formula or command or any function, but generally we don't use it. So I thought I should share it with you. These are some data values. A particular simple example I've taken: a cell is containing 5, a cell is containing 3, a cell is containing 4. There are different values available in cells. Now, in sometimes in working, we encounter a situation where we need to decide or we need to think what happens if I delete this value in the cell B5. Will there be any problem if I delete this value 5? So the solution we can easily find. Click on formula, press precedence or dependence. So what these things it will indicate this: if I am deleting this value 5, where I am getting impact, it will directly show us. So first click on precedence. What it is showing, the trace precedence command requires that the active cell contains a formula which includes variety of things. This means the 5, this is a value which is not dependent on any other value. This is a unique value and it is not dependent on anyone. However, is it the case dependence? Now I've clicked on the second option, trace dependence. So in the first case precedent, I came to know that this value is not dependent on anyone. However, when I clicked on the second option, trace dependent, I came to know that this value 20 and 45 is dependent on this value in the cell 5. So if I alter this value, let's say if I am if I alter this value, presently it is 5, that's created 0. So the impact you will be able to see on the dependence. So this is 0, this is 0. Look how, if I change this value, initially it was 5, I'm also getting the change here. So this is how you know it. When a value in the cell, is it dependent on anywhere, or does the value is unique? Is the value is unique, okay? So these are the arrows we are receiving. You can remove the arrow. There are two ways. You can only remove the precedent arrows. You can only remove the dependent arrows. Now I'm going to remove all arrows. Okay. So this was the precedent. Again, I'm creating file. For 20. So 20 is dependent on which thing? So this is 5 and this is 4. So 5 multiplied by 4, that was like this. Okay. Again, removing. Let's take 45. Precedent. What does this mean? Precedent means by clicking this, I'm getting where this value came from. That is, came from this cell and this cell. So 5 multiplied by 9, that is coming out as 45. Okay, so 5 multiplied by 9, 45. So I came to know that this value is the product of these two cells. So I don't need to alter these cells if I'm interested in this value. Okay. In the same way, I can know the dependence. This is how you know precedence, means a cell is dependent on any other cell, or a cell which is further dependent on any other cell. Okay, so precedent and dependent, you can check out from here. I will be removing arrows. Same case over here, dependent, no dependent. This value is not further dependent precedent. Okay, it is dependent on these two things. Okay, remove. So this is how you can check a value in any cell is dependent or not dependent. So next, we are having this data validation. Data validation. Okay, so this will take some time. Data validation, where do we have it? In the data validation. This is where we are having this data validation. What can we do in the data validation? Let's say I want to create this bill calculator. This is an example I've taken. I want to create this type of scenario. Okay. So first I need to have some input. So I've created this data initially. You will have to create your own list of products. I've entered tomato, onion, potato, flour, apple, and mini. You can enter again. And the price per kilo, 40 rupees kilo, tomato, onion, 20 rupees kilo, likewise. Okay, so these are the rates per kilo, and these are the products. Now, what I want a standard bill calculator over here. So, again, I have created a table. I have taken product, what is the price, what is the buy quantity, and it should all automatically calculate the cost. So, tomato, I need to enter it here, but it is a different way. Look at here, it is showing a drop down list, a list of selection. How do we create this list? We will only have to select this data. Okay, whenever you want to create a list, suppose here I want to create a list, and delete this. Then we'll go to data. I will say data validation. I will say data validation, and this is the pop-up we are getting. And which validation criteria it is asking? What do we allow? There are different options available. So recently I need a list. I'm clicking on list. Okay, I need to enter a list. What is the source of the list? Here it is asking. have selected this source, this will be my source. Additionally, I have taken two blanks. So in so if in future if I want to add another product, I will just type here, I will just type here in the next cell, and those also will be included in my list over here in the will calculator. So this is the space for expansion I created initially. Now I will say okay. Look at here, the list we have received. Okay, now select tomato. Okay, tomato. Done. This is the formula. Copy it. We will get list in each cell. Likewise, and see it here. And see it here. Okay. So in every cell, we have received a formula in formula list. If you want to add any further, let's say. You will also receive this in the list. Then final. Okay, this is it. So whenever you want to add something, that will also reflect here. Okay. So now I will go on with tomato. Let's say I'm purchasing some things. I'm purchasing tomato. Now what is the next column? It is automatically getting the price. If I'm selecting tomato. Here that is automatically coming 40 rupees. For onion, that was 20. That's it. Onion, it is showing us 20. So what I have done here, I have created a formula nested if loop. So if this cell is equal to tomato, I need to output this 40 value. Else, if again this value is onion, I need to create output as 20. If again this value is potato, I need to create this 35 rupees price. So in this way, with the help of nested if loop, I have created this formula. Now, we can go on with purchasing. Let's say tomato 1 kg, onion 1 kg, potato, let's say 3 kg. That's it. Okay. That's it. Total 165. This is the quantity of input. Calculated the cost. It's 40 into 140, 20 into 120, 35 to 3, 105. Okay, so 35 rupees per kilo for 3 kgs. So, you know, that is 105. What is the total 165? What are different colors? It is here, so it's current. Whenever we are creating paper, you want the user to interpret it easily, you may give these values. So generally what is given in Excel, whenever you, if you want some cell for input, you can select this cell input type. If any cell is giving hyperlink, you will select this type output. This is my output. This is the cost of fill total. So I have selected this output. Okay. Then this was only a note, use data validation with input message and error message. This is also what I wanted to tell you, hence I have written it in the note. What? I have done it. It is a note. So I have selected this type format. Okay. Excel itself gives multiple formats for you to enter the data. These are nothing but calculations. So I have taken this format for these sales. These are calculations only. So, selected this type. This is calculation. Okay. So, apart from creating your values, you can also define the cell type. Whether I need to only input it, whether the present cell is showing some output, or it is explanatory only, or it is a note only, it is calculation, what is warning, is there a warning? So, you can select the cells accordingly. Okay. Now, again, there is different option available with us. Let's say if I allow my customer only to buy whole numbers, means 1 kilo you will be able to buy, 2 kilo, 3 kilo, 4 kilo, will not be allowed to buy 1.5, 2.5, 2.7, 2.9, etc. Means I will not allow the decimal entry here, you will only be allowed to buy in whole number. Okay, so that is also you can create. Go to data validation, select the Excel lens where you want to apply this data validation, go to data validation. Now again it is asking the validation criteria. What you need to allow? I only need to allow the whole number. Okay, so if anyone is trying to enter the decimal, it will not accept. I only want to accept the whole number. If the range of the whole number you are also having, you can enter it here. Let's say from 0 to 10 maximum, you will be able to sell only 10 kilos of each product. So if someone is entering more than 10 kilos, you will not be able to sell. Hence the software should not accept it, or the application what you are generating should not accept it. Then click on OK. Now let's look at here. I will enter 2, it is accepting. I will enter 10, it is accepting. Okay, more than 10, I'm entering 11, let's say, I'm clicking. What it is showing? The value enter is not valid. It's not valid. A user has restricted values that can be entered into the cell. Okay, so it will say retry, cancel, help. I'm retrying, I need to enter again the value in between 0 and 10 only. So I'm entering 5, it's working. What we have again validated this type. We cannot enter the decimal. We will be only allowed to enter the whole number. So 3, 4, likewise we will be able to enter. Let's try to enter the decimal, 2.5, let's say. Again I mean creating enter, I'm pressing enter. This is the message I am again receiving. The value enter is not, it is not valid, because we have restricted the user, we have restricted this cell range to accept only whole numbers. Fine. So if you want the user to know initially that the application demand or the our requirement from them is only they should buy in full quantity, whole number, then you can also tell them with this input message. Okay, now select the cell range, click on input message, click on title. If you want to create any title, let's say instruction, the customer instruction, this here instruction, buy only whole number. Fine, buy only whole number. I will enter. Okay, if this is not the case, if you also want to create an error message, you will be also able to see this warning information stop. So let's say I will select warning here. Whenever user is not entering the criteria which we have defined, then it will show the warning. What will be title, let's say we will also keep it warning, and we will tell them please enter between 0 and 10. Okay, so please enter between 0 and 10 only. This is how we will be telling them. I'm clicking OK. Now when I'm selecting any cell, it is showing the input. Okay, I'm clicking it. So below you can see this thing, instruction, you have given this title for input message. It is showing buy only in whole number. So this is the input. When you will select any cell in this range, it will show you this input, buy only in whole number. Now whole number is 15 also. So if I'm pressing 15, telling warning, please enter between 0 and 10. This is also we have given. Please enter between 0 and 10. If you want to continue, click on next. Now I know that I need to enter in between 0 and 10 only. So I will give it maximum 10. It is okay now. Okay. So this is how you can validate the data, and you can restrict the user to enter the data as per your need. So in other way, you can at most foolproof your application or your data sheet. Okay, so this was the part I wish to share with you about data validation, and there are many more options available. You can just go here, settings, and you can explore all these functions. Okay, let's move further. What will be our next? Convert function. This is a general handy tool for engineering students, so I thought I shall cover it. Convert function. Okay. So how does it work? this is a normal formula, is equal to, you need to type is equal to convert, then in bracket value, which value you want to convert, the from unit you need to convert, and the unit in which you want to convert. For example, 1 meter is equal to 3.2 feet, okay, 3.28 feet. Now what if I am interested in converting this 5 meter into foot, but it is I am interested in converting this 5 meter into foot with help of the formula. So what I can do, I will use this formula, convert value from unit to unit. How? This is the way to do it. Is equal to convert. Okay, select the formula, convert, double click on it, convert. What is the value you want to convert? I need to convert this 5. So selected it, comma, then comma. From which unit you need to convert it? Let's say that is in meter. So 5 meter I am selecting. So from 5 meter I need to convert it into a different unit form. So now it will show us the value which can be converted from meter only. So we can convert it into inch, in foot, in yard, and else other else. Okay, so now I am interested in converting it into foot. I will double click on it, foot. Complete the formula with this bracket and enter. So you are receiving this 5 meter is equal to 16.40 feet. So this is how we generally use this convert formula. Okay, that is simple formula and happens many times handy in engineering calculations. Convert value from unit to unit. Hope you got it. Then let's move to further part. What do we have next? Type anything. And then what does this mean, type anything? Now what I mean to say, can you type is equal to A or is equal to B or is equal to anything in the cell? Let's try. Zoom it. Okay. Now I'm trying to type is equal to A and I want like this, pressing enter. Okay, it is not showing. Is equal to B, it is not showing. Is equal to my name, B A I B H A B. This is how I want. It is not showing. So how do we type this thing? So whenever you are trying to type anything, and this is giving you error like this, you need to insert this apostrophe symbol. This is being used before typing this symbol, apostrophe. First copy symbol. Okay. First, I will insert it here. Okay, like this. Then one typing. First, I have inserted apostrophe, then is equal to, and then A. Now it will show like this. Okay. Now we are receiving it. Again, apostrophe is equal to my name. Okay. It is showing that. Now you can type anything in the Excel, and it will not create error. Just before typing anything, press this apostrophe and you may go on typing anything. Okay. Then this was about typing formulas. Then the next part is import data from text. Again, this is a general requirement many times when we are having a large data, and from the data we want to create some analysis, and based on that analysis we need to make some decisions. So how do we do that? Let's take an example. Import data from text. Let's say here I will use a very old gadget of the time. Let's say this is a PDF. Is the PDF visible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's say this is the PDF. Here it is showing 70 pages. So this is a large PDF. It is having 70 pages in all. You can see on each page there are three students. So this is the first student, probably then this is second student, this third student, okay, likewise. So total 70 pages are there and many students are there. Now what we do, what we want to do, we only want to make a list of these students with their seat number, let's say, again. And this is the seat number of the student, B80, and this is the name. So this is the data we want to extract, okay. So what is the way to do it? This is a much large data, 70 pages in all. So I will show you the summary of the PDF. There are 53 pages, page number 1 to 53. On each page, likewise, 1, 2, 3. On each page, there are 3 students. Then page number 54. Page number 54. Only one student is there on this page. So this is one student. These are 3 students. From page number 1 to 53 and from page number 55 to 69, that comes out 15 pages, and again it has 3 students per page. Then page number 70, it is a single page and it has two students. So in all, in this PDF of 70 pages, the number of students we are having is 207. So I need to create a list of 207 students with their seat numbers from this PDF. What is the quick way to do it? What we will have to do, if we want to do this manually, we will have to select every time this cell. Every time this cell, we will have to select, then copy and then paste wherever we want. Then every time this cell, copy and paste wherever we want. This is the manual method, which will take a lot of time. So we will go with the data import wizard of the Excel. This is where it is available, data, and from access from web, from text and from other sources. Other sources are also listed here. So presently we are looking at this particular type from text. Okay. Selected a separate sheet for this. Now what is the procedure? The procedure I'm telling you, this is the PDF in which, from which we want to extract only the names of student and the seat number, and remaining everything you don't want presently. However, you will be able to analyze each and every field, each subject, each type, every marks, whether it's passed, not passed, everything you will be able to analyze it within minutes. This thing. So let's just select this data, control A. I have selected the complete PDF with control A command, that is select all. So I have selected this entire data. Now I will paste this entire data for that file, control B. I have pasted this data, complete data, in a notepad file. I will save it, save and close it. Okay. I will close it now. Then go to text data. Click on from text. This is the file from which we are interested to import the data. Let's click on import. Again, this will come fixed with. I will select delimit here because I need to insert my own types delimiters. So tab, I will also say wherever there is a comma in the text, put any further text in the next column. If there is space in between two cells, put this next part of the text apart from space in the next column. And this is how I will be able to get the data. This is preview. Okay, this is preview. So I'm okay with it now. I'll click on next. I will say finish. Okay. And this is where I received the complete PDF data in the Excel. Okay. So this was the PDF of 70 pages, and we need to import the names of 207 students from this PDF. So this is the raw data which we have created. you need to do, just click on this cell, look for something common. So what I'm finding here is this B80. I know that every student has his seat number starting with B80. Every student has his seat number starting with this B80. Okay, so I will use this information. I will select this column, go in conditional formatting, and I want to highlight only cells in which the text contains B80. Okay, now show me cells in which there will be this text B80. You can select the formatting. I will keep as it is, light red fill with dark red text. Okay, so this is how we are able to receive this. Click on insert, create filter, go to filter, sort by color. This is the color selected. This is the data of the students. Scroll below. This is name. This is surname. This is first name. This is father's name. This is mother's name. This is PRN. Okay, so everything we are getting here. Select this data. Okay, copy it. Control C and paste it where you want. Let's say I want it here. So first, I will delete this. Here, below this. So now, just make sure that you paste as values. Paste as values. Okay. I pasted it as values. Now, let's count this. Whether we have received this 207. Look at here. Count this 207. So we are successful in extracting all the students from this PDF of 70 pages with the seat numbers, with their names. Each column. Now I have already told you okay to combine this name in a single cell. We will be able to combine this with the help of concatenate formula. Okay, in this way we have extracted student data within minutes. And this is how we use the import data field in the Excel. Let's move to further part. Next. What is next? Import data from web. Okay. Why do we need to import the data from web? Because many times the data are precious on the internet. For example, gold rate. Gold rate of 1 gram, 24 carat. It is changing per day. Okay. Share prices are changing per day. Petrol and diesel prices are changing every day. Okay. So whenever you come across a situation in which the prices are changing every day and the prices are listed on a particular site, particular page on the internet, and you wish to use this information and you wish to use this information available on the internet, and from using this information you wish to create some useful formula, then you will have to select data and from web. Okay, so what I have done here, the way I will tell you, I wanted to have gold rate of 1 gram 24 carat. Okay, so this is the today's rate 4841 in Nashik. Okay, so from where I am getting this, I have taken this from here. So this was a website which gives a daily gold rate, and the Excel file, my Excel file is directly fetching the data from the internet, and it is showing me here. How do we do it? Go to from web. Okay, this is where you will have to insert your URL. Let's say I want to insert now. It will load much time, so I will not demonstrate over here. But I will tell you the method. Data which you want to insert from the web, the link you will enter here. Okay, the link you will enter here. You will press OK. Then the web page will load here. After loading the web page, whatever data you wish to get, you will select the data like this. There are some sites on work. Okay, let me start. Okay, it takes much time, so I'm not trying to demonstrate it. Just rather, I will tell you the method. Enter the URL, select the part of the web you want to insert, and then the Excel will import everything on the web page over here. Likewise, I imported the gold rate, that was a website which was giving daily gold rate. I have imported the data. Now I have just selected this thing and is equal to C723. This is where it is. Okay. So this is automatically refreshing. Refresh rates you can also change. Right click on the data, go to data range properties or refresh. Data range properties, you are having options for refreshing the data from the internet. Refresh every 60 minutes, or you can change this minutes. Okay, like this. So what is the rate of refresh you would like to set? I have set here enable background refresh or refresh data when opening the file. So whenever I will open this Excel file, every time and when it will be connected to internet, it will go on that gold rate website. It will check today's gold rate and it will show me here. So I will not have to go to again that website for checking the gold rate. Yeah, so this is how you get the live data from the internet into Excel sheet, and you can make it interactive. Okay, so let's move further. Index. Then next we have with us this remove blanks. Now this is also a case. I will delete this. This is example I have taken. First, let us delete this. We are having this table. Okay, this is the table we are having. And what is the problem in the table? Many rows are blank. Okay, this is blank. This is blank. This is blank. So this is how the table is not looking good. It is having some values, but many rows inside the table are blank. So what I need is I want to remove all the blanks in the table. So what is the way to do it? I will select this row. I will click on delete. I will select this row. I will click on delete. So in this way, I will be able to manually delete all the rows. But when, let's say you have thousands of rows, okay? Let's say this is only 28 rows. Let's copy it. Insert it again. Copy. Picture now. Okay, now we have 109 rows, and again whenever you have small data you can do it always manually, but in this case when you are having this big data, okay, it goes now. These are 217, almost 217 rows are there. And many rows are blank in between. This is blank. So what is the way to remove all the blanks on the rows? The way to do is select the columns in which you would like to remove the blanks. Press Ctrl C. Okay. Then click on Spatial. Okay. Then select this blanks. Blanks. Okay, what it has done, it has selected only the blank cells. Can see? Okay, it has only selected the blank cells. Now press Ctrl plus and minus. Is it Ctrl? I'll show it here. Ctrl plus and minus. It will pop up this window. Now select this option, Shift Cells up, and just click OK. Okay, you can see every blank is removed. out of those 217 rows, means 2000 rows, the blanks are removed, and now we are only having 97 rows. But again, there is a problem that I copied some rows to create larger data, and again, if I want to remove the duplicates, just go here. The command has already told you data, remove duplicates, from all selections now. On OK. Now, 84 duplicate values found and removed. Only 12 unique values remain. So this will fill data, and now it is available without none. Okay, so this is the visible data now. This was about removing the blank. Next, we have this is pivot table. Again, the same example I have taken. Let's say this is a data table, and if you wish to create this data in the pivot table format, just select this table, click on insert, select pivot table here. Then these are recommended pivot tables, anything you can select. You go on.
कुलकर्णी सर आवाज नहीं है फिर
हेलो हाँ आई एम सॉरी इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम लगा ओके सो आई वाज एट द पिवोट टेबल एंड सिलेक्टेड कंपनी साइज एंड देन आई एम आल्सो इंटरेस्टेड इन नोइंग द कॉस्ट So after selecting all things, company, size and cost, this is how my pivot table is looking like. So this was my initial data. This was my initial data in this format. Now this data.
Sir, screen share kara.
Okay, screen share. सर जिस क्या था हेलो
यस यस
ओके हाँ आपला पहले सा टेबल होता डेटा टेबल त्यामध्ये काय होतं कंपनी वेगवेगळ्या कंपनीज होत्या साईज होत्या स्मॉल स्मॉल मीडियम रेमंड व्हॉट वॉज द कॉस्ट फॉर दिस मीडियम शर्ट ऑफ दी रेमंड कंपनी दिस वॉज द टेबल ओके नाव आफ्टर क्रिएटिंग दिस टेबल इन पिवोट फॉर्म पिवोट टेबल फॉर्मॅट looking data in a different way. Okay, so the pivot is not only about looking the data in different from different angles, but it is also about generating direct reports from this data. Now in this example we are having a very small data. I've taken only 3 columns, and that is also very simple. Companies, then the size of the shirts, and then the costing of the shirts. But in this example also I can create it in very different ways. Okay, after clicking here, look at this field, drag fields between the areas below. So what if I want to see this table in a different way? What if I want to create companies in column? So these are the rows, these are the columns. In the columns presently the field is nil. I will take the companies, just create drag and drop. Take this company and press here. Place it in the columns. So you can see all the companies are now listed in column. Okay, then if you wish to create size also in the columns, again it will expand. Now the companies and below and in the size in columns, large, medium, small. So, but this is not the format which I am in which I am interested. Again, I will revert back because it is not useful. It is not very useful in viewing. Again, I will pick size in rows. This is a good table, and I think I will be able to analyze it effectively. So what I'm having here, large size, medium size, small size, then companies and their costing is here. Okay, this is the costing. So what is available here is given here, sum of cost. Okay, these are costings. These are costings which are available here. Grand total, it has automatically calculated in vertical and in horizontal also. This was not available in our data. Okay, look our initial data. This was our initial data. And we didn't have the summation of each company or summation of all products or summation in any format. But what pivot is giving us, it is giving us grand total of each company of each size. And again, for special large of all companies, it is giving grand total. For medium size of all companies, it is showing the total. So this is how the pivot table can be used. One more thing in which pivot table can be used is to create the reports. Now this data is very less, but what if we have a large amount of data in which we are having multiple scenarios? For example, in our case, if we are an educational institution, we will be having the student and then all the data of the student, all his records from first year to last year, and many more fields might be there. So what if I want to create a form depending on our user wise, that means student wise, so I can do it here. Right click on the pivot, any cell in the pivot table, go to pivot option, just enable this display option, click on display and then classic pivot table. Okay, then classic pivot table, okay. Now look at this option available here, drop report filter, fills here. Now, let's say if I want to create separate report for each company, Alain Soli, LP, Raymond, Vanishen, for each of the company, if I want to create a separate report, what I will have to do only, I will take this company tab, I will pick it and I will drop it here. Okay, I will drop it here. Now go to insert, go to insert, analyze, then click on option. After option, there are three fields highlighting, in which click on show report filter pages. Click on this report. What do you want? Show all report filter pages of company. I want all pages. I will click OK. Now what Excel has done, it has automatically generated each report depending on the company. You can see it. You can see it. Okay. This is a separate sheet. Look here on the tab LP. This is the separate sheet of LP. This is the separate report. You can directly print it on Control P. Just go on Control P and the separate sheet is available with you. Okay. The same report directly for Raymond with size, for large size, for medium size, for small size, with costing and grand total, everything included for company, then for Vanishen. So what we have done, we only had this data in the raw format. We created a pivot and the pivot enabled us in looking the data in a very different ways, and the pivot table also enabled us in making reports of any tab. Means I can make a report company wise, I can make a report size wise, I can make a report cost wise. So, and again in that, I will not have to enter any single text manually. It will automatically create my all reports. I will only have to print. So this is where pivot table comes handy. this was a small example of pivot table. You can explore many other options in pivot table, and after continuously using it, you will be more favorable with it. Go to next. After pivot table, let's just first cover data entry forms. Data entry forms. Okay. So this is another part I wish to tell you. This is the same data again I'm taking. Let's say this is the data I'm having. Now, first to create a data entry form, select your data and format it as table. Okay, this is the option available here, format as table. I've selected it, selected my area of the table, my table has headers, yes, company, size and cost, these are headers of the columns, and I will say okay. Okay, now it is converted into table, a table format. Now click on any cell and go over here. This is quick access toolbar. Here you can say many options. Okay, so from these options go to more commands, then commands not in the ribbon, and then select form here. Okay, already inserted in my case, so it is showing here form. You need to insert this thing, form. Okay, so I've taken it here, form. Now click on any cell and click on this form. It will create a form directly. And now you can go on with finding next thing or previous thing, or you can add new, you can delete the existing record, you can select a criteria. For example, I need to find a criteria. I want to find small. Enter. Then everything small, it will show here. Then next, only small. Okay, so with the small category, it will show all records here. Where does this help us? When we have multiple data, let's just say for students, when we are recording data for the students, here we will generally say serial number, then name of student, then everything gets 10 marks or 12 marks, then first year, second year, third, and it will go like this. It will go many times. After entering data, it goes here, and we generally lose track of what was here in the initial cell or what was in the top. So in this case, rather than moving in horizontal direction, it is better to move in vertical direction. Just click on form, and if any option is there, it will list it vertically. Just go on entering and enter. Here, rather than, what is the way to insert a column here? What is the way to insert a row here? Let's say if I wish to insert a pay here below, then a company. Let's say I started my own company. Then small. So this is the thing I want to insert as a row. So this was the manual way to insert. I will enter the company name, I will enter the size of the shirt, and I will enter the price for it. Okay, this was the manual way. What is the way with the help of a form? Just go to form, enter company name, we'll enter the company name. What is the size? Small. Okay, what is the cost? It is 2000. Click enter. Look here, it is located. Where it was small and 2000. Okay, so it is located. Again, we need to enter the data ABC. Part size. Enter to receive data. Okay, you can enter multiple data. You can delete the previous data. Let's say this is ABC and I don't wish to keep it. Just click on delete. Okay, look here, it is removed now. So this is the way to use the forms in Excel. Also has this scroll down. So if our fields are multiple and it is many fields are in horizontal direction, it is a very long form, then it becomes handy and filling this form in vertical direction likewise. So everything you will be able to see what we have entered. And if you initially it was 3200, again if you look to the store, this option is available, this square feet, double zero, you find previous and the criteria I told you. Okay. So this is a way to create data entry in a better format. Okay. Then too much. So I push to again share it with you that we can create whatever we wish in the Excel, because it is only a tool and it is up to us how we use it.
Sir, तुमसे आवाज खूब स्लो ही तो है.
हेलो, आते हैं तो मैडम.
हाँ, आते हैं तो है सर.
हाँ, this is a general application I've created where I will do create my own time management tool. You can add activities here, for example breakfast, the category you can say it is it necessary, the activity you are performing, dinner it is necessary, breakfast it is necessary, playing game it is not necessary, so this is time wasting. So enter your activity, say whether it is necessary, product it is, this activity is productive or the activity you are mentioning is time wasting. Just click on the activity. Here again, drop down list is there. Select your activity, whatever you have entered activity, it will show here automatically. Enter your time of the activity, it will calculate the hours in duration. Enter your age, then considering 70 years of life span, the remaining years in your life is 40 years, let's say, then it will calculate automatically everything, what is productive in 2 days, 0, necessary 20.8 hours, what time wasted 1.3. And if in the same rate, this is the graph, it also generates automatically depending upon your activities performed in a day. So on the daily basis, it is tracking. So TV, you have watched 0.3 hours, then study, you are not done. Lunch, getting ready, face games, dinner, breakfast, everything. This is the sample I have entered, sample some activities I have entered. And accordingly, it is giving me inputs. Okay, so if I'm not doing any productive work in today, and I'm doing my necessary works in a day of 24 hours, out of those 20.8 hours are in my necessary activities, and I'm wasting my time 1.3 hours out of 24 hours in some time wasting activities. So if the same rate continues, the projected days in a year at the same rate, I will be wasting 20 days in a year. So projected years in my remaining lifespan of 40 years, I will waste 2 complete years. So this is where you automatically get it. I've entered the formula again over here. It will automatically show. Let's say if time wasting is let's say 9, so it will show different value. It is now 15. You are about to waste 15 years of your life from remaining 40 years of your life. Okay, so it will automatically calculate the time what you are means spending for 24 hours. It will generate a graph and track every activity. It will project you how much time you are about to waste in your life. So this was, and then the final, it was only a tool. So this was just an example. For example, I shared it with you, and in this way, whatever we wish to create, we will be able to do it with different commands. Then final is Excel templates. Excel templates are almost in the menu format. They are already available. We don't need to do much. Just go new file, open, create new, and in this new there are this templates listed. Okay, so according to business, according to these are the parts. Let's for our educational institution, and we have it's a business, then according to business, these are the standard templates available for marketing, brochure, sales, for sales, which is available. You can directly use these templates. It is readily formatted and for formulas also entered. And you only need to enter your data. The template is education. This is available. What is available under education certificates? There are many templates available. Let's say this is a project plan.
सर एक्सेल टेम्पलेट कुठे
आहे? न्यू मध्ये, न्यू फाइल मध्ये गेल्यानंतर न्यू.
अच्छा अच्छा, ओके ओके.
न्यू मध्ये आल्यानंतर आता फॉर एग्जांपल आई विल इन्सर्ट दिस प्रोजेक्ट प्लॅनर. आई विल से क्रिएट. ओके, आई शूट दिस. सो दिस इज डन. व्हाट इज माय ऍक्टिव्हिटी? माय फर्स्ट ऍक्टिव्हिटी इज लेट्स से वेबिनार प्लॅन. ओके, सो दिस इज वेबिनार. When do I plan to start? From the first period, I wish to start. What is my planning duration? 2 days, let's say. So 2 days, now it is showing in 2 days only. This is actual start, this is percent complete. Actual start, let's say I couldn't do when I planned it. I started it on 4, so showing it 4, and then actual duration, it was 3. Accordingly, whatever values you will enter, percent complete, let's say my work is now 100% complete, I will enter 100, will show 100% complete. Okay, invoice are also shown above here. Okay, so just go on with your project planning activity, enter your activity, start your plan date, plan duration, actual start, actual duration, complete, percentage completion, and the project planner will show you the progress over here. Okay, so in this way you can use multiple templates, and almost for every purpose Excel has already created a template for our use. We only need to find the right template for us. Okay, so I think I've completed my webinar.
Hello sir.
हाँ बोला ना.
ते इंडेक्सचा हायपरलिंक कसा मिळत होतो? मी तिकडे इंडेक्सच्या सेलवर क्लिक केले, तिकडे इंडेक्स ओपन होते.
ओके, ही इथे.
हा हा, ही
हे ना. आता फॉर एग्जांपल इथे इंडेक्स आहे, इथे इंडेक्स टाइप करतो. टाइप एनीथिंग यू वांट टू हायपरलिंक, गो टू इन्सर्ट, दिस इज हायपरलिंक ऑप्शन, क्लिक ऑन दिस ऑप्शन हायपरलिंक, एंड these are 4 options available with us. Now what I want to place this reference in the present document only, so place in this document. I will click on this thing. Okay, now where do we wish to go after pressing index? After pressing index, I need to go to index. So this is these are the fields, this introduction, then index, then next is 1 2 3. So this is the index I need to go to after pressing this index button. So I have selected index, and then okay, that's done. After pressing index, I will go to index. Okay, hyperlink.
Okay, yes, yes.
Okay.
So, sir, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Okay. I think I have completed my presentation.
Chan sangitlo, sir, tumhi.
Thank you, madam. मुलं तर कोणीच नाही मॅडम, पण काय करता.
नाही पण छान सांगितलं, खरंच मस्त सांगितलं, खूप गोष्टी कळल्या म्हणजे. थँक्यू वन्स अगेन सर.
यस, थँक्यू मॅडम. कुलकर्णी सर नाही आहेत. आय विल कम अप अँड आय विल टेक युअर लीड. यस सर.
ओके,
बाय
बाय
बाय सर. मॅडम सर्टिफिकेट तर काय प्रश्न नाही, आपले आहेत सगळे. फीडबॅक ऑब्जेक्ट नाही टाकले,
आपल्याच लोकांना देऊन टाका.
फीडबैक लिंक नहीं टाकली, मी शेअर करू का फीडबॅक लिंक?
हो करा करा.
हा एक मिनिट, फीडबॅक लिंक शेअर करतो मी.
हो चालेल.
बोला ना सर.
अहो मी ते आपोआप मला आउट झालो तुम्ही.
ओके
छान घेतलं सर, नाईस प्रेझेंटेशन.
थँक्यू सर. मुलं पाहिजे ना सर?
म्हणजे काय काय
मुलं पाहिजे होते म्हटलं.
मुलं नव्हते आता सध्या, ठीक आहे आपण नंतर एक मोठा FDP किंवा एखादा प्रोग्राम करणार, त्यावेळेस तुम्हाला परत संधी राहिलच. तेव्हा टीचर्स वगैरे असतील तर आपण चांगलं होईल, अजून काही प्रॉब्लेम नाही. पण छान सर, म्हणजे खूप काय म्हणतो आपण त्याला, एक्सेलचे एकदम डिटेल तुम्ही सांगितले,
खरंच छान सांगितलं,
खूपच छान सर. कीप इट अप, कीप इट अप. थँक्यू सर. थँक्यू दंडगे मॅडम.
ओके
सर, देन
ओके सर.
सर मी फीडबॅक लिंक शेअर केली आहे. फीडबॅक लिंक शेअर केली आहे म्हटलं.
केली का?
हो सर.
हो
सर्टिफिकेट
ओपन झाले.
त्यांना प्रश्न पडला, सर्टिफिकेट आपल्या दोघांना द्यावं लागेल सर. एक विद्यार्थी होता ना तो आल सहित काहीतरी
मध्ये लेफ्ट झाला असेल सर, मी प्रेझेंटेशन करत होतो त्याच्यामुळे इकडे लक्ष
नसतो. लेफ्ट झाला बरोबर, त्याचा काही कॉन्टॅक्ट नंबर असेल तर पाठवावे लागेल.
ओके
बरे, काय हरकत नाही सर.
आउटसाइड पीवीजी अजूनही एक मेंबर होता कुलकर्णी सर.
काय
आउटसाइड पीवीजी अजून पण एक मेंबर होता?
कोण? मी
नाही. तुम्ही आउटसाइड पीवीजी होता बघा ना, आता गेला वाटत. अभिषेक होता. अभिषेक
असं मला सांगा ना कुठे कसं लक्ष वेधायचं. मला त्यांच्या मोबाईल वरून तुम्ही करताय?
नाही नाही, मी त्याला पाठवलं होतं, म्हणजे आमचे सर मास्टर आहेत एकदम, तुला अटेंड करायचं तर कर.
थँक्स टू दंडगे सर आल्सो.
गेलाय पण त्याने लेफ्ट केली आता.
यस
ओके.
चालेल चालेल सर. ओके
ओके
ओके.
बाय बाय
बाय.